George Floyd Square at 38th in Chicago has changed a lot in the last couple of years, and it will soon be home to a new business. Kaya Edwards tells us why Chopped and Served Catering chose this location despite all that has happened there.
Over the years, Chopped and Served Catering has worked within many kitchens. Now, for the first time, founder and executive chef Imani Jackson has her own brick-and-mortar shop.
Oh, I'm pumped, baby. I'm ready.
Once renovations are complete,
we had to cut 2.5 inches around this entire border.
They'll offer cooking workshops in one room and healthy meals for purchase in another.
Instead of having sit-down seating like there was before, we're just going to have like grab-and-go, take-and-bake food, kind of like Papa Murphy style.
This used to be Dragon Walk, a restaurant. Just months after it moved into the building in 2020, George Floyd was murdered across the street. Between the unrest that followed and the indoor dining restrictions, the business didn't last. And since then, bullets have hit the building. Still, Imani chooses to be here.
As a Jew, our memorials around the world for the Holocaust don't look like this. They'll be like beautiful stones. Why don't we get that as black folk? So that's kind of the message I want to be able to help portray, the narrative of like, we are so powerful, we can have more than just this. Good energy, positive light, smiles, humanizing the dehumanized, which is this entire corner. Knowing people's name. Chopped and Served has a powerful energy where we can do that.
Save the date. Chopped and Served Catering plans to open October 1st. Kaya Edwards, Carol 11 News.
Well, Chopped and Served frequently provides free food to inner city kids. The company plans to extend that offer to the whole community at its grand opening on Monday, October 3rd.